Everyone.
Good evening.
I'm Leanne Powers. I'm the music director here at Redeemer. And we are going to present to you our handbell choir, maybe playing one number. And then the choirs, the adult choirs of Redeemer, will be doing a cantata that is introduced to you in the program. We have a wonderful accompanist who has come in. She's coming to help us out, and that's Kim Ernst right here. And we also have a wonderful Peter. Our Peter character is quite a character. You'll thoroughly enjoy him. At the end of the service, there will be two young ladies at the doors with offering plates if you choose to give a donation. Totally up to you. And it is quite okay. I need permission. If you like the program, you may have Thank you.
If you know any bell players, I'd like to get off that end of the table, thank you. Pastor Dave?
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Father in heaven, we give you thanks and praise for all the blessings of this day. We're grateful for the witness of Palm Sunday and how it draws us to contemplate your marvelous passion, your sacrificial, your life-giving passion. Lord, we're all looking forward to Easter. We're all looking forward to the call of Peter to be a strong witness to Easter. But first, we pause to consider Peter on Holy Thursday, Peter on Good Friday, Peter after our Lord's crucifixion. Lord, we pray that as you gave Peter the strength to see his way through those difficult times, you will be with us in all times of trial and tribulation. Lord, we're trusting in that. We're praying for that. We're looking forward to Easter. We're looking forward to Peter's witness and pray you make it ours. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Did it make? Oh, hi everybody. My name's Peter. You might have guessed I'm a fisherman. And you would not believe how hard it is to parallel park a boat around here. I had to grab a snack, so I got some worms and some fish. If anybody gets hungry from tonight's performance, let me know. I'll hook you up. But I guess we better get this show started, so. What is your passion? What is your call? I cannot claim that I felt a strong passion for anything as I spent my days on the banks of the Galilee. I was just fishing my way through life. Today's catch supplied today's wages, and I had little thought of tomorrow. I assumed I would live and die on that fishing boat. Follow me. From the shore, Jesus called out. Follow me! And a passion stirred in my heart that changed who I was and who I would become. I followed him for 3 years. With my own eyes, I saw Jesus do and say many wondrous things. But even though you have not seen him, all who love him and believe in him may also be filled with an inexpressible and glorious joy, a holy passion. What is your passion? What is your call? Jesus says to you, follow me. If you hear and respond to these words, they will transform all that you are and all you will become.
Is the answer to life on this earth.
Jesus says, come, follow me. Though we don't know where he will lead us, I am persuaded that he who calls us by his glory and goodness will give us everything we need for this life. The knowledge and passion that leads us to follow him will bring us abundant joy and peace. My commitment to follow would be tested when we were once again on a lake. From our boat, we saw Jesus walking on the water. My passion sent me out to join him on this miraculous walk, but the experience tested my faith and taught me a lesson that I never forgot. I saw Jesus walking across the sea.
Oh, I saw Jesus walking across the sea. I said, help me walk on the water. That's where I want to be. He said, go where they will take you. Now come on out to me. He said, come on out to me. So I stepped out on the water, but I wasn't sinking down. I stepped out on the water, but I wasn't sinking down.
But the wind,
then I felt Jesus, he was holding on to my hand.
Then I felt Jesus, he was holding on to my hand. He said, up
a little faith you have, you pour and now go back.
Rise up, put your faith in me, and surely you will stand. Now rise and stand on the mount of Jesus.
We go wherever faith will take us. We live through stormy and turbulent times, and through it all, we must humble ourselves under his mighty hand, that he may lift us up in times of trouble. Cast all your cares on him, because surely he cares for you. And if you suffer and stumble in your faith, God will make you strong, firm, and steadfast. More than anything, I wanted to be bold and strong in my faith. So one day Jesus asked me, who do you say that I am? Without thinking, I blurted out, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Well, he had never claimed to be the Son of God, but those words were planted in the depths of my soul, and I knew they were true. He looked at me and he said, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church. All at once, I knew there was no turning back. This was no longer just an adventure, a break from my life as a fisherman. My life's work would be to follow the Christ, the Son of the living God.
Upon
this rock,
I'll build my church. Upon
this rock,
I'll build my kingdom on this earth. I'll build my church upon this solid rock. Upon
this rock,
I'll build
my church.
Upon
this rock,
I'll build my kingdom on this earth. I'll build
my church.
Upon this rock, this solid rock.
And we say, you are the Christ, you are the Son of the living God. You are the Christ, you are the first begotten Son, born from the love of heaven. And we are the church, and we will serve and glorify. We are the church to be a living sacrifice, offered to you through all we are.
And so our love, will be the cause, the reason why we live our days to walk in faith,
in
the rock, the solid rock.
Shout it out now. Upon
this rock,
I'll build my church. Upon
this rock,
I'll build my kingdom on this earth. I'll build
my church.
Upon this rock, this solid rock, I'll build my church. Upon this rock,
I'll build
So let your love for Christ be the cause of all that you do and say as believers and as a church. You are like living stones being built into a spiritual house. Live as a chosen people, belonging to God, that you may declare the praises of Him who called you out of darkness into His wonderful light. Sometimes the road will lead us from lightness into darkness. As I followed him into Jerusalem, a crowd welcomed us with shouts of joy. But there were evil forces at work. Though I could feel the danger, I was undaunted. Even on the night of his arrest, I was ready for whatever would come. As we shared our last meal together, I told him I would never leave or forsake him. And to this, Jesus made a disturbing response. He told me that I would deny him 3 times before the morning cock would crow. I had left everything to follow him. I committed my life to him. How could he have so little confidence in my loyalty? Well, Jesus knew that I would soon be tested beyond anything I could imagine. In the face of mortal danger, he took us out to pray at Gethsemane on the Mount of Olives. Stay awake and pray with me, he told us. But even as the Lord prayed with great anguish, we grew tired in our praying and fell fast asleep.
Here at at Gethsemane. Come, friends, and pray with me. The evening stars will give us light. Stay alert. Keep watch. You don't know what is waiting for us on the other side of the moonless night. Father, you can do all things. Please take this cup from me, but whatever may come, your will be done. I'm distressed, I am grieved. Father, take this cup from me, but whatever may come, your will be done. Simon Peter, are you asleep? The spirit is willing, the flesh is weak. Pray you are spared the time of trial. Wake up, Peter, why do you sleep? Couldn't you pray 1 hour with me? Soon we'll walk the final mile. Keep alert, you don't know when trials come and troubles ascend. Keep alert, rise and stand. Look, the betrayer is at hand. He is at hand. God's will be done. God's will be done. Stay awake, pray with me. Stay awake, pray with me.
Stay awake. Rise from your spiritual slumber. God's work is at hand. Stay awake and pray that you will stand strong and faithful to the Lord. This world will test you physically, financially, spiritually. Pray that God will make you strong, firm, and steadfast through whatever trials may befall you. My most severe test will come that night when they arrested Jesus. I followed close behind until I got outside the chief priest's house where Jesus was being held. Soon there, the people began to recognize that I was a follower of Jesus. My fear and panic began to grow. He called me the rock, but soon all the courage and confidence of this great rock would melt away as my loyalty was severely tested. On a cold, dark night, I stood by the fire near the place they had taken my Lord. I saw him there with shackled hands, wondering what was in store. Then the people all around started looking my way. They were closing in on me. And I said anything that I could say, just so that I could go free.
Deny, 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 deny him, deny, deny my Lord. Oh, how will he forgive me? I'm going away to cry.
I told him I would never leave him. How could I have failed him so completely? While I ran away and cried bitterly from my guilt and shame, my Lord stood alone before his accusers. No, I wasn't there. I cowered in my hiding place while my Lord was out there being tried before Pilate, the Roman governor. When Pilate asked the crowds, "What do you want me to do with this man called King of the Jews?" they shouted back, "Crucify him!" And so Pilate had the Lord flogged and handed him over to be crucified. I still regret I wasn't there. While I waited in my safety, my Lord was taken, clothed in a purple cloak. They placed a crown of thorns on his head. They struck him and spat upon him, stripped off his clothes, and led him off to be crucified. No, I wasn't there. John stood by Jesus' mother and Mary Magdalene. From a distance, they watched as the Lord was nailed to a cross and crucified. The soldiers divided up his clothes, and people from all around came to mock him and taunt him in all manner of abuse. At noon, the sky became as dark as the night. How lonely and abandoned he must have felt as he cried out, "My God, Why have you forsaken me? He gave a loud cry and breathed his last. Jesus had told us, there's no greater love than when one dies for a friend. How weak was my love that I could not be there with him in his final hour. They took his body from the cross and laid it in a tomb that had been carved out of rock. Then they rolled a stone across the entrance to the tomb. He called me his rock, and in his darkest hour, I wasn't there. I felt I had failed him in every way. Shock and despair gripped me in the days after his death. As I tried to accept the fact that he was gone, Mary came to tell us that they found his grave empty. So I ran to see for myself, and even after I saw the open tomb and the empty shroud, I thought that someone had stolen the body. But now I understand what that empty tomb means. For Christ died for sins once for all to bring us all to God. He was put to death in the body, but made alive in the spirit. So the sight of that empty tomb is our reason for being. That empty tomb is what gives us a passion to live the new life that we find in Christ.
Inside the golden garden room and see where the blood
Jesus said, "Follow me." Two simple words that changed my life. Follow me. Two words that will change the life of anyone who responds. What is your passion? What is your call? My friends, rise up and be all the more eager to make your calling and election sure. For if you do these things, you will never fall, and you will receive a rich welcome into the eternal kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
And so our love for Christ will be the cause, the reason why we live our days to walk in faith, faith in the rock, this solid rock.
And we say, you are the Christ, you are the Son of the living God, you are the Christ, you are the first.
Upon this rock, I'll build my church. Upon this rock, I'll build my kingdom on this earth. I'll build my church upon this rock, this solid rock. Upon this church, upon this rock.